Easy, calm down.
A lot of knowledge Charlie has.
Now, this is an important aspect of the game. They're going to leg to see who breaks first. And as you know, Kim, being a former world champion, getting the break in eight ball is a major advantage.
Well, it sure is. Like you said, you were in the green room, and Loree Jon ran 10 racks. Well, what happens if she gets the lag in one and then breaks and runs 4 or 5 or 6 racks?
She's got it right here. Now, they're playing eight ball, which is different than nine ball, which is what currently is on television. I think Charlie is going to give the rules here in just a moment.
The match will be 2 out of 3 sets. Race to 9, the first one to win 9 games wins the set. Ball in hand, fouls only, resulting in ball in hand anywhere on the table. You must call the ball and the pocket, especially if it's not obvious, and especially for the 8 ball. Winner will break. Again, cue ball, fouls only, ball in hand anywhere on the table. Any questions?
No.
Ms. Jones, you won the leg. Do you want to break, or would you have a Sigel break? You will break.
Emphatically, she wants to
break. One. Break is a huge advantage. And what Charlie didn't mention there, a lot of people don't know, if you make the eight ball on the break, you win the game. But the break is a huge advantage, and this is why Sigel thinks he has a big advantage in this match, because he thinks he can break better than a woman.
Well, he most definitely hits them harder than Loree Jon, but sometimes if you finesse the balls and just hit them at a perfect speed, you will make a ball. Very important for Loree Jon to get off to a really good start here.
Well, she's convinced she can win this match.
Match is underway. Now, she doesn't have to stay with a stripe or a solid. Whichever goes in, she then gets to pick what she wants to play.
Right. This is important for people at home watching, because in professional eight ball, she makes one ball. She has an option to choose either the striped balls or the solid balls. She has to clear all those balls out first, then and call every pocket, the ball and the pocket, make the eight ball to win.
Well, she couldn't ask for a better break here. She's all set up. The balls aren't really together or anything. So what she really needs to do is take advantage and win this game.
Now, this is an important aspect. She's, you know, like you said, the balls are wide open, but there's a couple things down here that people who are watching at home need to know. The pressure that these two players are under, they have been practicing more than they've ever practiced and prepared in their life of pool. And Kim, you know this, being around pool your whole life. This is the biggest event in pool history, the biggest prize money. There's more celebrities in the auditorium watching. Again, we had to turn away hundreds of people at the door.
15 in the corner.
It's the biggest event in pool, and pressure has to play a huge issue here, don't you think, Kim?
Well, I really think that's what it's all about, Kevin, the pressure. I mean, whoever handles the pressure the best. I mean, Mike is such a great player, and Loree Jon, too. So there isn't really much reason why she can't win, other than maybe she will not handle the pressure as good as Mike.
Now, she's a native of New Jersey.
Pocket.
Makes her home now in South Carolina. And let's also remind everybody, she shows some nice touch there, that on a scratch, it's ball in hand.
Anywhere on the table, which is unlike most amateurs play at home.
Combination, 9 into the 13th side pocket.
In professional play, if you scratch, then the opponent gets the cue ball anywhere on the table, which is a huge advantage for a professional. So you are heavily penalized if you scratch.
Right. I really think she shouldn't have played the combination here. Anytime the balls are wide open, no need to play a combination. She's in trouble here, it looks like. She has to hit this shot really well to get back and to get position. It's just the combination really could have cost her this wreck. I mean, she's going to have to draw it back for the 14 in the other corner, so she needs to hit this very nice.
Now, drawing it back is harder, because on this table, we are now using in the International Pool Tour the traditional nap cloth, which is much slower than the cloth that most people are familiar with watching on television, which means you have to stroke the ball much harder.
11 in the corner.
Than you normally would on the newer fast cloth. This is the traditional cloth. Let's see what she can do here.
Yeah, you're there, right, was a Kevin. Lot of indecision before that shot.
Yeah, but Kevin was talking about the cloth. That's true. That's Moscone and Fatch used to play on this cloth right here. I mean, it is slow. You really have to know what you're doing and have a good stroke.
Now, she didn't stroke that ball well, so right. She has a big problem here. She has to cut this ball into the corner pocket, and she has a problem here.
She doesn't like her leave at all, does she?
This is a tough cut, Kim.
Yeah, it is. I mean, actually, she has two ways to play this. She could play it in the side, and then the cue ball come off the end rail and go back up for the nine. But it looks like she's looking at the corner pocket. So, I mean,
either way, she left herself a tough shot.
She did.
She didn't have to.
14 ball in the corner.
The combination got her in trouble. See, I think she should play this ball in the side pocket because the angle's going that way. You never really want to shoot away. Like, she's shooting away from the center of the ball. If she was to shoot it in the side, then she'd be shooting with the angle.
That way, you can hear a pin drop down there. I mean, these players are playing for more money than they've ever played in their life in pool. It's the biggest event that they've ever been in.
I was talking to both of them, and they really are nervous. I mean, they really are.
And she's playing high English to get follow.
She made a heck of a shot just to make it. And then that's kind of a bad kiss. She went right off the two and in there. I mean, you can't legislate for that kind of roll like
now,
that.
Now, Mike Sigel has cue ball in hand anywhere on the table, and he's got all the balls wide open. Now, Mike Sigel is the favorite. However, he hadn't really played competitively in 10 years. He came virtually out of retirement. Youngest man in the Hall of Fame.
The foul resulting in ball in hand for Mr. Sigel.
Voted greatest living player. But here's the thing with Mike. He quit the game because there was no money in it. He's come out like every other Hall of Famer now to play in the International Pool Tour because the money's so big. I'll tell you what, he is under pressure to win this. But the last time he played competitively a few years ago,
one
he broke
corner.
A cue stick. He couldn't handle the pressure. So no one knows what's going to happen with Sigel here.
But she really set the table up nicely, though, for Mike Sigel. Let's face it, after that mistake, he's got a huge opening here to capitalize on.
Well, this is what, in pool terms, we call a road map. When all the balls are laid out and you can basically just pick, and pick them off. And Mike shouldn't have no problem here. But then again, there is an insurmountable amount of pressure on these players. There really is. I mean, this playing for this kind of money and winning this title.
Let's remind everybody, $150,000 to the winner.
And the world
champion. It's never, ever happened before in pool, this much money in one single match.
And it's the world champion. It's the IPT World Champion. The start of the biggest pool tour in the history of the game with the most prize money in the history of the game.
He's going to come two rails out of the corner. As you look how slow that cloth is. He tried to shoot this six ball for the side pocket.
In the corner.
And it stopped for the corner. He would much rather have been out and shot it in the side pocket. I mean, he's lucky that the cue ball didn't get over the eight ball, but now he just can bridge around it a little bit. Mike's such a great shot maker here. This should go just dead in the center.
Eight ball in the corner.
Nice leave.
Again,
yes. This has got to be devastating for the young lady in the corner.
Game one, Mr. Sigel.
So a Hall of Famer and a legend of that, Mike Sigel taking game one. First set. Need to get to nine. A closer look at Mike Sigel.
That's the way to do it. My parents bought a pool table. One day, I walk up, I grab the cue, I hit like three balls, and I knew that's what I was going to do for the rest of my life. I won over 100 tournaments, and I think there's not too many people on the planet that do that better than me. But when I was a kid playing pool, you never saw a woman in a pool room. Loree Jon Jones, I've known for many years. She's a great player, and it's going to be a real test of talent. You can see, when you watch this match, you'll see my break over her break. It's night and day difference. Now, there's a lot of great women out there. I'm not taking nothing away from their game. I just think the men are just much better. All the pressure is on me. She has a free shot. If she wins, you'll never hear the end of it. If I win, I'm supposed to win.
Shades of Bobby Riggs and Billie Jean King.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you know, I was in the green rooms earlier. Both of these players are freaking out
game
under
two.
The pressure. Really, you have no idea how much pressure. Now, you notice he's breaking from the center of the table. He's not using a side rail like you see on television. That was instituted later. This is the way you're supposed to break. Now, look at him bend that cue stick.
A scratch on the break with a lot of action.
Yeah, I mean, he broke him really well. You can't know that the ball is going to come around and kiss in the side like that. This is exactly the way it's supposed to do.
Bam. Boom. Scratch. Yeah. Now, ball in hand for Loree Jon. Open table. This is a huge advantage. She can run this out.
Yeah, she has to. I mean, she didn't take advantage of the first game, and I hate to keep harping
Your
on
choice.
That, but she has to. Has to get out and at least stay with Mike.
Now, the break is important. Mike scratched on that break, which, look at him. I mean, you can watch him break 50 times and he's never going to scratch on the break.
Right.
So for him to scratch, it was a big error. But it's important because the winner of the game gets the break on the next game. Now, that is traditional pool. If you win, you get the break again. And if you win that, you break again. And if you win that, you get the break again. So you could basically run a whole bunch of games in a row once you get into that rhythm. Then the other player is sitting there getting cold. So for, you know, Mike got the break, but he may be giving it back now.
Well, she is lining up another combination.
You don't like this, do you?
I don't like combinations, but there's really no need to shoot combinations unless you absolutely have to. That's like a bank shot.
Combination, 11 into the 13.
She's won over 50 championships. It's kind of hard to second guess her. I know that.
Yeah, 8-time world champion. One of the greatest women players of all time.
And she's been in a tough position before. Let's face it, guys. She's dealt with adversity. She won her first championship at the age of 15.
And, you know, the thing she's noted for is she is really the comeback. They call her King, Queen of the Hill because she's the comeback player really of the decade. If when she's down, even if it's by a lot of games, her ability to come back is really unparalleled in the sport.
Good touch. Now what about the leave though?
Well, her position play, she just doesn't look like she's just quite there yet. She's still a little nervous. I mean, she's kind of tipping and tapping on the balls instead of, you know, like a fluent full stroke. See, she could get, you know, see, she's undecided.
As you know, just like in golf, you can be hitting the ball perfect on the practice, you know, area, and then go to the first tee and fall, you know, just the wheels fall off. And that seems to what's happening here. She was playing phenomenal in the green room before the match, and now I think the pressure of just walking out into the stadium is having an effect.
Yeah, she just looks a little undecided to me. I mean, if she was playing this rack at home, she would beat out 100 out of 100 times.
Now, early pressure on Loree Jon Jones, who comes in the decided underdog.
Combination.
Now she's going to go for another combination.
Another combination.
She's not playing this rack right.
She has to be careful with her position. She has to make the ball first, but then position is key here. She has to be careful.
Tough miss.
This is a tough combination anyway, but she shouldn't have had to shoot it.
No, she should have, the cluster she shot when she first started, she should have broke those balls out instead of messing with the other combination.
Now, in pool, we call that digging yourself a grave because she was running balls, but then she knew that she was going to have two balls stuck at the end, miss, and now Sigel's up with a wide open table.
Yeah, and with all the balls out, I mean, she only has two balls left. Mike's such a huge favorite to win this game. Actually, Loree Jon will have a hard time getting back to the table.
Kevin, as we see here, the big difference between the slow nap and the fast nap.
It's huge. Obviously, the top is the fast, the bottom is the slow. You have to hit the ball so much harder on traditional nap cloth, which means the margin of error goes up, which means you have to be a much better pool player to play on slow cloth than you do on the fast cloth. And that's the difference in the International Pool Tour. We use the traditional slow nap cloth. This is just a tougher game you're watching right here. 8-ball is a tougher game than 9-ball. The slow nap cloth, breaking from the center of the table instead of the side rail, the tighter pockets, and when it breaks, you're going to see the better player dominate in the International Pool Tour.
Yeah, really Loree Jon Jones can tell you that after the miss. A wider pocket, she probably makes that combination on the side.
You're exactly correct. She just missed that by a hair, and it would have went in if it was a regular.
But you're right. You hit that right on the head there, Kevin. I mean, the equipment is so much tougher than it was before. I mean, this cloth and this in these pockets. And if you watch Mike and you watch the way he's shooting and he's pocketing the ball, it's much cleaner, much more crisper than Loree Jon. Even though he's had some antics at the table, that's just Mike. He's always done that. But he really can hit balls clean when he's playing well.
Now, he didn't get in good position here. So he's got some tough choices.
He might be showboating a little bit, Mike the Mouth here. I think he knows what he's going to do.
Don't buy it, do you?
they call him Mike the Mouth Sigel because he talks nonstop. But I'll tell you something, and you can tell by the pressure, he ain't saying a lot.
He always likes an ear man. When he was always in the tournaments, he always likes somebody to talk to after he shoots, before he shoots, you know. He wind up talking to himself a lot.
Three ball in the corner.
Let's see what he's going to do here. I think he's just going
to. Again, you always have to call the ball and the pocket, not the way it gets there. Perfect.
No combination for him. Sliced it perfectly, took the good angle.
Okay, now what is he doesn't like this.
He wants to be straight in every shot.
If he's not perfect.
Yeah. He could make this shot in his sleep.
He's done this his whole career.
Oh,
though.
Yeah.
He has been voted the world's greatest living player, and it's on display right here.
Oh, yeah. There's no doubt. I mean, when he is playing his best, he is so fun to watch. He just makes no mistakes, just zero mistakes. But he told me earlier he is very nervous.
Perfect.
Come
on,
baby.
Get position?
Come on, baby.
Oh, now he's starting to talk. He's loosening up. Yeah. See, he's got a game. Now he looks like he's going to win another one. He's starting to get the mouth going.
Now he's going to get the position for the eight ball, which is kind of on there. It's pretty easy, right?
Yeah, he could just roll it down a little bit. Yeah.
Eight ball in the corner.
Loree Jon made one mistake, and she just sat there, and it cost her a game.
Game two, Mr. Sigel.
Closes it out after another mistake by Loree Jon Jones.
I mean, if you think about it, it should be 2-0 Loree Jon.
Yeah, right. Not too bad. I was trying to play the five, get in the middle of the 3-7. Seven up in the corner, a three over there, and the ball just went
Does he know this guy? He just talks to anybody.
Yeah, he just talks to anybody. Well, maybe there's Jimmy and Nick. Maybe he was talking to them. Yeah. Who knows?
So a 2-0 lead early in set number one.
It's the glorious results of a misspent youth.
Now, because he won, he gets to break again.
If he gets this break working, I'll tell you what, Loree Jon might not get up
game
for five
three,
or six
Mr.
games.
Sigel,
I mean, this guy, if he gets
tonight.
Rolling, he's just a freight train. Offensive right, juggernaut Mike is when he gets to rolling.
Nine-time world champion, winningest player of all time, youngest male player in the Hall of Fame.
Watch this cue ball. When he's hitting them really good, the cue ball will go up about 18 inches, 16, 18
no.
inches.
No.
Oh, and he scratches again.
Hit it again.
Mm.
And this didn't get kissed in. Look, just straight in.
Now that's twice
a big miss hit,
in
Kevin.
A row.
Let's take a look at the fours with cue vision.
He went for years without scratching on the break. Look at a cue ball. I mean, he just off hit it just a little bit, and you can see how it brought it over towards the right.
Now, Loree Jon's got to get something going here.
Itis. Charlie side pockets.
That's two breaks in a row he scratched, which is unbelievable. That's got to do something for your confidence on the break, doesn't it?
Oh, I would think so. And Loree Jon has shot every game so far. There's been three games she shot every game, so she really has to think, hey, maybe I can win.
Again, cue ball in hand for the professionals. When you scratch, you pay the price. So your opponent, in this case, Loree Jon, gets to put the cue ball anywhere on the table.
Well, she's not shooting a combination.
I was about to say, that's got to be an omen in the positive direction. No combination to start things off in game number three.
Four ball.
There she goes. She's looking a little more confident. Well, the balls are open, but both of these players have left an indelible mark in the game of pool. I tell you, both of them are just fantastic.
Now she's shooting the solid. She's got pretty much a wide open
Six
table
ball
here.
On the side.
Sigel is really upset because he knows she should easily run this rack out.
Well, Mike knows if Loree Jon gets to playing really well and if the balls start going on the break, that she can do the same thing that he's doing, run three or four racks or something.
Seven ball in the corner.
See, she needs to draw this ball back. She don't need to stop it. It needs to come back a foot or so. All right. She hit that
and you good. Can see the cloth. See, it's slower. It's the traditional nap cloth. You have to hit the balls harder and stroke the ball better on this cloth than you do
Fine
on that
on the side.
Fast cloth that they're using on other tours.
Oh. See, she just over...
Stroked that.
Overstroked it. I mean, she was thinking this cloth is so slow. But I've talked to four or five of the players, and they put nap cloth on their table, and they are practicing.
Two ball in the corner.
Religiously.
Now, she doesn't want to have this huge angle. She wanted to be straight in on this.
This is the same shot she scratched earlier, if it's somewhat, on the first game, but I think she'll be fine here.
4.5-inch pocket. It ain't the big ones.
Pocket the ball.
It isn't the big one. And now she missed.
I'm a wreck.
I know you are.
She missed this by a mile. It's a tough shot anyway.
A mile.
But watch this, watch this, watch this. Watch this now.
A mile and a half, Kevin.
Yeah. Now, even if that was a 5.25-inch pocket, she still would have missed that ball.
I got to loosen up.
And she's absolutely right. She is just a little bit tight. And she had an opening once again. We saw Sigel sitting over there in the corner shaking his head in disbelief that he opened the door for Loree Jon Jones. But again, she didn't take advantage.
But he can't believe he's back at the table shooting. But notice what she did do. She put that ball.
I'm looking.
It's blocking the pocket.
Ooh.
What he can do if he can't get to the ball, he can shoot
safe.
Her ball. His ball and shoot her ball into the corner.
Now hold
and
on.
Scratch.
He just said he wants to play
right.
safe.
That goes
he
knows that counts, correct?
Yes.
Okay. See, he that's knows that that ball that she put there to block the pocket.
I know where I'd like to put the cue ball.
All right, it's a family-rated show.
Well, I think he's going to shoot the 14 and make the two and put the cue ball behind those two balls there, those
right.
two stripes.
Play
and snooker
safe.
Her.
So he's playing safe to give her. She'll get a chance to
safety.
Shoot again. But he's trying to make it so that she doesn't have a shot and can't run out.
Right. Just it looks like the 15 and 13, he's going to just marry him right up together, all three of them. Okay. That's a pretty good shot. He'd like to got a little closer to him, but that's okay.
Could have been better.
Okay. That's called playing safe. You have to hit your ball first, which is a stripe ball, which he does. He doesn't make the stripe ball, which means your opponent now shoots.
It's all part of the strategy. It looks like she might be able to play a little curve shot on this, Kevin, and make this. I think he's not too happy with it.
No, I was afraid.
Of course, he wouldn't have been happy with it if he would have got froze up to it. Mike's never happy. That's why he's such a great champion.
See, what he did here. There, look at him talking. Mike the mouth. Talking to anybody back there.
Yeah.
Because he's figuring that Loree Jon is not going to be able to run out, and then he'll get back to the table.
Okay, she's going to elevate her cue and hit down on it, and that'll curve the ball around the 13 and make the three. Watch the curve.
There we go.
Just not quite enough.
Cut it a little bit too much.
Swerve. Again, with the size pockets, Joel.
You're right.
It was a good try.
It was a very good try by Loree Jon Jones. Degree of difficulty off the charts on a shot like that, as Kim described.
But it was smart on Mike Sigel. See, Mike Sigel played and made that decision where other players may have tried to run out or whatever, and he played that safety.
What did he say? He doesn't believe it? Is that what he said?
That he doesn't have a shot now.
Well, it could have been worse. She could have made that, Mike. I mean, then what?
Cup's always more than half empty.
Yeah.
11 in a corner.
Here he goes.
That's right. Look at it. Look, he doesn't have a shot here.
I tell you, when he was at his best, this was a hanger for him to make.
Let me look at this.
Hanger, for those who are watching, of course, in pool, we know what that means. The hanger is the ball that you can just basically, blow into the pocket. It's like hanging right in the pocket. It's easy.
Love it in the corner.
When you hear the term, it's a hanger, it means it's a real easy shot. You can close your eyes and make it. And so this, as Kim, 15 years ago, Sigel, this shot was a hanger. It was an easy shot. Now, his heart's probably going 100 miles an hour.
That's the voice of Kevin Trudeau. We remind everybody, the founder of the International Pool Tour, as Paul Sorvino looks on. We have so many people from Southern California, from the industry, here taking it in. Kim Davenport with us as well, former world number one.
Does he make it? Does he make it? Does he make it? Oh, baby! Yeah.
Center of the pocket. What a shot.
How about that touch?
And he almost broke those balls out.
Not over yet.
Not over yet, he says.
Maybe it is.
Maybe he'd have something to say.
Well, he likes the chances once he got to the other side of the table.
It appears, Kim, that the nerves are showing more on Loree Jon in her shooting and selections than Mike at this point.
Well, she has made countless number of mistakes already, Loree Jon.
14 in the corner.
And that's just nerves.
Yeah, just nerves. I mean, because like I said, if she was at home, it was no problem making the shots that she's missed.
I'll tell you what. A half an hour ago in the green room, she had no problem.
Combination 15-13 corner pocket.
Combination,
Well, that's what he didn't like when he went to the other side of the table. He made that comment.
Watch the 15.
Does he make it? No. Oh, he does. Oh!
He put a little funny English on that to make that. That ball didn't look like it was...
I'll tell you what, that's a tougher shot than anybody at home has any idea what he did. He played reversed English to spin the cue ball so it actually spun the ball that went into the pocket until it got the right direction.
It really did.
He could go up here 3-0.
Yeah.
Oh, he didn't get right on it.
No, but it's pretty much.
Uh-oh.
15 in the corner pocket.
Missing this.
Now, hold on. Look, he's got a tough cut here.
Well, yeah, he does. But
is he going to scratch on this ball?
Oh, I think he'll just shoot it right in. I mean, he hasn't missed a ball yet.
Oh, he jumped up.
God almighty, Mike. You didn't have to miss it that bad.
Oh, he jumped up a mile. Now, watch this.
Look where it hits on the rail. Look how far he missed it.
Ooh! He tried to play high inside English or reverse English, so he got in better position and didn't scratch. And because of that, he hit it way too thin.
Free ball on the side.
He also jumped up.
Oh.
And just like a golfer over a putt, you can't move your head. You can't jump up.
Yeah, he really jumped up on that. Well, Loree Jon finally says, I get an easy game.
Hey,
don't worry, I used inside English for you.
Husband Sammy finally with some reason to smile and celebrate. And it should be automatic for Loree Jon Jones to finally get in the win column.
Game.
So she's on the board.
Come on, girls.
Yes, and it counts.
I'm a little nervous, but I'm all right now.
A 2-1 lead from Mike Sigel. Sammy loves it. He'd like that $150,000 paycheck at the end of the day, even more as we take a closer look at Loree Jon Jones.
I started playing pool at the age of 4. I won my first tournament like at age 11. I'm an 8-time world champion. He's a 9-time world champion. You have the best of the best playing against each other. He's a phenomenal pool player, and I have my work cut out for me. Sigel making a statement that men are better just because they're men is a ridiculous statement. Mike is definitely a chauvinist. I'm going to bring duct tape to the match, and if he just bothers me, I'm just going to go over and just right over his mouth. The amount of money on the line is huge. I want to win. I'm going to just outplay Mike.
Great attitude, and what a world champion she has been. So the 5-time player of the year will get the break after her first win of the match. We continue in set one. This is game four.
It just shows one mistake at this level, and your opponent is going to capitalize, and that's what Loree Jon did there. Does she make a ball?
Something fall.
Oh, she got a ball. Big difference in break, Kim, between Mike Sigel and Loree Jon.
It's not even close. As you can see, she kind of really, I mean, you didn't get a lot of splatter on them balls. They just kind of just drilled. And she got really fortunate. The last ball almost rolling went in the side four.
And again, because it's professional eight ball, she made a striped ball. But she does not have to choose stripes. At this point, because it's professional, she can choose either the solids or the stripes as her group.
And it's a very critical time now to make that decision. You know, take the solids or the stripes. And a lot of times, a lot of the players don't make the right decision here. So let's see if she can look it over. Well, Sammy might have her some advice for her. He's looking it over, too.
He's a player, too.
Yeah, Sammy is.
And he's a good player.
He really is.
He's actually a member of the International Pool Tour as well, playing on the tour.
He's a former professional player and is still Loree Jon's coach.
11 ball.
And that was a confidence stroke.
Yeah. It looks like now she's got the first game and the last game is always the toughest to get when you're playing a match. So she's got that game under her belt. She's only down by one game. So I look for her to, you know, do some good things here in this rack.
Now, as we know, she has the break. She could run 4 or 5 games in a row easily.
She has a little problem, the ball, the 7 ball up there with the 12. She needs to somehow break that loose or something. That's going to be a problem for
14
her.
Ball in
the
corner.
She can get it pretty early.
Right in the heart. You can hear the sound of the chalk going on the Q-tip. Amateurs don't do that. You need to put chalk on your Q-tip.
13 ball in the corner.
Every single shot.
That is correct. She's going to try to get it right here. The 12 ball up by the 7.
Ooh.
Not the leave she wanted, though.
No. No, she overstroked that ball, actually. Oh, it's in a bad position now.
It got worse.
Oh, God.
And she was trying to knock that ball out so she had a shot on it later, and now she's dead with it. At some point, she's going to have to face that ball.
9 ball in the corner.
She has a chance to knock it out here again. The angle is good.
Here it comes, here it comes. Did she do it? Ooh!
Now God bless her.
She's trying.
Yeah.
She tried to get it off the rail, not only off the rail, but it's up against. That's solid.
This is what an amateur doesn't know how to do. Not only make the ball, but spin the cue ball around so it comes, boom, into the ball you're trying to knock out to give yourself a shot later. She's going to try it again. Here it comes. Here it comes. Oh. Because she knows she's dead unless she gets it out of the way.
Three times.
Look at this.
Three times in a row.
Just straightened out on her.
And she hit it twice. Yeah. It's still the best of us.
Well, that also shows that the slow nap cloth being used is different than the fast cloth most people are used to seeing on television. If that was the fast cloth, Kim, that ball would have flew out and just opened up like crazy.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Yeah, you can see where you really have to put a super stroke on this ball. She needs to try to just play some kind of safe here. Maybe I don't really know how. She needs to leave the cue ball on the rail somewhere. But look at all the balls. I mean, there's really no place for her to run or hide. She might want to just pick a pocket and just shoot it as hard as she can, hope something happens.
What do you think she's going to do here? Do you have any idea what she can do?
Well, she's going to try to leave the cue ball on the rail somewhere where he has a tough shot. That's only
so
really
she's not trying to make the ball.
No, I wouldn't think so. I mean, they're just really.
Because she has to call the pocket right. If she were to try to make. So she's just trying to play safe. Siegel's going to get a chance here.
Oh, without a doubt, Mike will get back to the table. Yeah.
Not many options right now for Loree Jon Jones.
Well, I seen her point her finger down there. Looks like she's trying to get behind the 6 with the cue ball to block. The ball laying in the side pocket there, so he can't just shoot it straight in.
We already heard Charlie Urcetti in the background calling for a safety.
Now, there's no shot clock on the International Pool Tour.
Safety lap.
It's not a bad shot.
Not a bad shot. Well, she must have got the schnooker then, huh? He can't shoot the ball straight in?
7.
7 ball in the corner.
As I was mentioning, there's no shot clock on the International Pool Tour, just like there's no shot clock on the PGA Tour in golf when, you know, Tiger Woods is looking at a putt.
Can't believe he got it there.
And so
this
is what,
hanging.
This is what's happening here. Mike and Loree Jon have a chance
play 7.
To 7 think
the
about
corner.
Their shot.
It's by the hole. It's a difficult shot, the distance.
He's on the rail. It's tough. Oh! Just barely made that.
And it didn't even sound that clean, did it?
Oh, it wasn't that clean. It went back. It was like a bank shot.
2 ball. Side pocket.
It's Paul Savino in the background there.
Looking pretty intent, too. He loves pool.
Now he likes all of a sudden, you see the eyes, all of a sudden, the table's opening up. He likes his chances.
Yeah, 3.
3 in the corner.
Again, Loree Jon had a chance to win this.
1 ball in the corner.
Now there's a rhythm to Mike Siegel.
Now, Mike Siegel did all the technical shots in the movie The Color of Money with Paul Newman and Tom Cruise. But a lot of people don't know that movie, the Tom Cruise character, was virtually the Mike Siegel story. Mike Siegel was the left-hander, like Tom Cruise in the movie, that couldn't be beaten. and was taken on the road by an old-time hustler, Larry Hubbard,
who was
one of the greatest players in the world. And Larry taught Mike how to hustle pool. And Mike used to go into pool halls with Larry Hubbard and basically, as he would say, rob the players out of $10,000, $20,000, $30,000.
You think Mike likes his chances here just a little?
Six in the corner.
Yeah, I think
a little spring to his step. Nicely.
Yeah, you're right about that, though. I remember I was out in 79 is when I first started, like, filling with pool. He was up in the Bay Area. I heard there's some left-hander up there robbing everybody.
Yeah, yeah. He could be. Could miss a shot. This is for the money.
Well, he's making out like a bandit right now.
That 3-1? 3-1.
3-1 it is.
Thank you.
Score is now 3-1. Favorite, Mr. Sigel.
Heat. The he is heat. Fuck is a. I got the five. Believe me, isn't it a five? What is that, a hanger? You'll have to stop dead or draw it in the rail.
There's the mouth talking to anybody who's in the earshot.
That will listen.
All right, let's get this break working here. I think it's time
really
for that.
Scratched on the last two breaks.
A little five pack or something here?
A little five pack. He's meeting. When he says five pack, run five racks
here?
In a row without Loree Jon shooting. That's what he
What's
meant
the score?
By a five pack.
3-1, yes.
It's got one of the best breaks in the world, even at his age.
Look at that.
That sounded a little better.
Hey. Now look at the difference between this and what you saw with Loree Jon. Balls flying everywhere.
And notice the cue ball went up in the air and then come back and stopped at rest. That's what you're trying to do, is just kind of, we call it parking the cue ball.
Well, some action. Also the cue besides the ball. And let's join Claudia Jordan now.
Okay, we've got Mario Lopez here. Obviously a big pool fan. He travels with a stick.
Yes, everywhere I go, it comes with I'd be very into the game, so I start to practice my shots mentally and physically, obviously.
So what's your connection to the game? Like, how do you feel about pool?
I love pool. I got to tell you, it's been a special part of my life with my father, because we grew up with a pool table, and some of the best conversations I've had have been with my dad over a pool table. So over a game, to this day, it's very much, I can talk to the letter. Oh, no, I can't. To this day, it's still very integral part of my life, because we still, you know, we'll have a couple drinks, we'll play pool, talk, and it's just more about the time we spent, but it happens to be while we're playing pool.
Three in the corner.
Time. I really appreciate it.
All right, thank you. All right, bye.
Thank you, Claudia. So we continue now in game five. Sigel up 3-1. We've never seen anything like
four
this in pool. It is the biggest payday in the history. That young lady on the downside of things right now, but when you see Mario Lopez, Paul Sorvino, so Pauly Shore, Eric Dickerson in the stands, so many people, because we've never ever had this kind of opportunity to sit in on a match of this magnitude.
You know, here we are at Mandalay Bay too, where all the big fights happen.
Ho!
Wow.
And we have Tommy the Hitman Hearns is also here.
One thing about it, both players know what's at stake. Large amount of money. Mike looks like he's just.
He didn't like that last leave.
No, but it looks like he's settling in. I mean, he's made, I think, one mistake, but it looks like he's. Really,
well, that one mistake cost him a game.
Well, it did. And he's.
At this level of play, I mean, Loree Jon, one mistake, Loree Jon comes up and just wins.
Well, and she should have. It should have been 2-2, as we watch. You know, she just she's nervous.
It could have been 3-1 the other way right now.
It really could be. Players don't like using this. Is called
five
a
in the
bridge.
Corner.
They can't reach for the shot. It's difficult to play with the bridge. You have to really practice this. It's something you just can't. You're not born with.
The snooker players, the European players, are more apt to using this than American players. Isn't that true?
Yes, they are. They use it very well too.
Now, Mike again. Virtually has been in retirement for 10 years, even though he is the winningest player of all time, youngest player ever to be inducted
in
the Hall of Fame. And because of the enormous amount of money now in the International Pool Tour, Mike, just like every other living Hall of Famer, has come out of retirement and are now playing again because the millions of dollars that are at stake in the International Pool Tour.
Right, and that's just, it's phenomenal. I mean, finally, pool, you know, it looks like it's really going to go somewhere, Kevin. I mean, finally.
Throwing off.
Oh, I'm sure he'll make it. Oh, I'm sure he'll make it. He was straight in. I never thought it would have hit that. Thought it would have right in the center.
Yeah, glad you were so certain. He didn't feel that way once it left his pool cue.
A little nerves, maybe.
But speaking of nerves, is this guy a bundle of energy? He never stops.
The mouth.
Two in the corner.
Eight
ball on the side.
But this is a tough shot here.
It's not automatic, is it?
No, because it's a little off angle, and plus the ball next to it, the nine ball, he's thinking, well, if I twitch a little, maybe I'll hit the nine. I mean, you know, so
he's looking to see. This is not an easy shot at all.
He's looking to see maybe if the cue ball will scratch. It's one he should make. Let's put it that way. I would hate to bet against him not making it.
But this is the pressure shot, though.
Right.
To go up 4-1.
Amazing. Oh, he missed it.
Wow, Kevin, I don't believe that.
You see, this is the second time he missed the ball and he jumped up. He jumps up, boom, right there.
Nerves. That's all it is nerves.
Well,
he's
it's
jumping
just,
like that.
It's just like, and it's his wife. That's just like Tiger Woods or a professional golfer over a 2-foot putt and missing it because they jump up. Movement. Although that was not an easy shot at all.
No, it wasn't, but still, it's one that, you know, greatest living player here now. He should have made that ball.
Yeah, his
wife Renee always saw.
He knows.
They expected it as well.
She has good form. Look at her. Stays down, no movement. See that? Even though she didn't hit in the dead center, her form's very good. Loree Jon's always had great form.
It's constant adjustments, though. You've talked about the slower cloth. Also, the tighter pockets that they have to all of a sudden hone in on. So throughout the course, and especially early in this match, it's going to be a period of adjustment.
She left herself with a really tough shot here. She did not leave herself good position at all. She made that shot. She made it look easy.
And she left herself in a good position to the opposite end of the table.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but it could be a little better here, though. I mean, both balls she's looking at, she has to cut.
Well, she noticed this
in the corner.
There were three balls here frozen on the rail. She's got two more to contend with. So making the shot is one thing, but then getting the position for the next shot.
That's always key position. That's why the great players make it look so easy, because once they get in line, they stay in line.
And the eight ball's in the middle of the table, so if she misses, she knows it could be over for this game.
She's going to have to play some good position here.
Nope. Oh, she made that one.
Look at the cue ball. Again, she's keeping herself with three balls on the table. There's really only one ball that she can play. She keeps getting herself out of position.
14 to the corner.
Door is open.
She should just make this and bounce off a little bit and have the 10 ball for the corner.
Oh,
good leave.
Which is exactly what she did.
Snap.
She's always been a good, and we talked about it, a good come-from-behind player. She's trailing right now 3-1 in this game 5.
Well, she's probably one of the best come-from-behind players in the history of the game.
I would say, without a doubt, probably so. She's won so many matches from behind. That was a nice stroke. She let it out there, and Mike knows he missed the 8. He's still kicking himself in the rear.
But that was a funny place to put that. To go for that, I guess the side pocket's okay.
Right. Well, she's such a great player that she can make the cue ball do anything. I would just roll it up and bounce off and shoot it in the corner. Let's see what she looks like. She's trying to shoot it in the side with a lot of English.
Yep.
Oh, she didn't get far enough.
Ball on the side.
I think that was a mistake there. Now she has a really difficult.
You would have played that in the corner.
In the corner, yeah. Now she has a really difficult shot. I mean, it's not the hardest shot in the world, but it's not the easiest either.
Yeah, she's got it.
Well done. And she needed it. Husband Sammy looking on her coach. So Loree Jon Jones down by only a game in this opening set.
And look at this. Again, tough shot here. Make sure she doesn't scratch. She has to play a lot of high English on that. Now, that game, you saw a great shot making on Loree Jon, but Kim, what you didn't see is great position play. She wasn't moving the cue ball around and getting into position for the next shot as good as she can.
Right, and playing 8-ball, that'll catch up with you, because in 8-ball, you have to tiptoe around the balls. There are just so many of them. It looked like she let her stroke out
a
little
bit. That
was a
much better break.
More comfortable.
But has she made one? I don't believe she's made a ball.
She didn't make one.
So.
Now, our Q-Vision break comparison, her action as opposed to what we've already seen, with the ball not leaving the table, like we have 12, 16 inches off the table from Mike Sigel.
And here's Mike Sigel.
Yeah.
And the break in pool is like a drive in golf. If you can drive it far in the fairway, you have a big advantage. So if you can break really hard and make balls on the break, you have a big advantage in the game, especially when we're playing traditional rules where if you win, you get the next break, winner breaks, which allows a player who starts to getting in rhythm and starts to get in stroke and get a roll going, they can run 3, 4, 5 games in a row, or racks in a row, as we call it, and pull running racks.
Right.
All right.
Mike Sigel sizes up the table now.
15.
He's thinking about 4 or 5 shots down the road, Kim.
At least, yeah. It looks like he's called the stripes here. So I believe the combination is on the up by the 9, where the 9's in the corner there. Those 2 balls look like they're tied up, but everything else looks good. Loree Jon has a little look of concern on her face. She'd really like to get back to the table.
Again, each set here is a race to 9, so the first player to win 9 games wins the set. And to win the championship, you need to win 2 of 3 sets.
Yeah, just because the player loses the first set does not mean that they're out.
Correct.
It's not so automatic, is it? They're bunched together pretty well
off the break. Yeah, they are. And what I don't like, he's calling the big ones, but look at the 8-ball with the 3 and the 6 all around it, like surrounded.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he has to have a plan after he, after he's looking at everything, he has to say, well, all right, how am I going to get this 8-ball out of
there? 15 in the corner.
Well, this is not necessarily a rack that you can plan on running out. You may have to plan on playing a safety and letting the opponent get to the table.
Right. He was trying to break him out now. He did break him out.
Yes.
Look, that was a pretty good shot.
This is a perfect example of the difference between 9-ball, which we see so much of right now, and playing stripes and solids, old traditional 8-ball.
Right. Much tougher game.
The
much
congestion
tougher
on the table.
And once you commit, if you don't run the balls, once you commit, you're pretty much going to lose the game. Look at this. He broke him out again just for safe measure.
And that's something an amateur would never do.
And he shot that right-handed. You folks at home that didn't notice that. Mike can play really – I'm sorry, Kevin. Mike can play really well opposite hand. One of the very few players that can do that. There he goes.
He broke
out. The 8-ball for down the road.
Okay. Tug of the pants, and he's off and running.
With an exclamation point with that nod of the head.
He actually went out and bought a new shirt and a suit for this tournament yesterday. He went out shopping here in Vegas.
He has always made a little tug on the pants
corner
ever since I've known him for almost 30 years now. And if he gets tugging on him too much, you're in trouble, because that means he's really playing well.
Not superstitious, though.
Oh, much very superstitious. He has to remember, slow cloth. He needs to put a good stroke on this to draw it out. Look.
He didn't do it.
He didn't do it.
He's all right.
Well, he's okay, but he would have loved to have been a foot further out.
Right.
11 in the corner.
He's picked up the pace a little bit, it looks like.
Does he do anything slowly?
No, he fishes fast. I was with him fishing. He was like nonstop casting.
Yeah, according to him, though, every time he catches one, so he has to hurry up. He's going to catch all the fish in the lake.
Is he getting position here?
I think it looks pretty good on the side there.
13 in the side.
Yeah, he'll just draw it straight across, come in between the 7 and the 4, and get in the middle of the table. There we go, yeah, good shot.
Now, if he runs us out, it was one unbelievable tough run out.
Really was. He broke the 8-ball out. He broke the 2 balls out twice. Which Loree Jon had 3 chances to break 1 ball out and couldn't even break 1 out.
That was a serious look of concern we saw on the face of Loree Jon Jones.
Seen this before.
Now look here, he just missed the 8 ball last game. You think he's thinking anything?
Oh, that's a very good point.
Yes, there it is.
up in the bowl. How about that run out, huh? This ain't even in the ballpark. Huh? I had to move like 9 balls that wreck, that's all. I redeem myself.
Score is now 4-2.
It's unbelievable, isn't it? Unbelievable. You know, the shot on the 8 in the side, I'm playing on this table, and I just don't see it. I don't see the shot. It's like a guess. Yeah, there you go. I'm trying to keep it close. This should be a blitz.
Listen to him.
Run 3-4 racks. I mean, when's that coming?
You think he's confident? This should be a blitz.
I redeemed myself. Oh, yeah, bump the 3, bump the this one. Huh? Yeah, right.
Mike the mouth, always talking,
it ain't
jarring.
Easy being me.
It's not easy being Mike Sigel.
Just for the cue. He always lifts the cue up.
Fight with that guy.
Jam it.
Loree Jon, look at Loree Jon. She's just
Game
sitting
7.
There stewing.
Mr. Sigel leads 4-2.
She's steaming.
Well, it's a pretty sick feeling right now not to be in control of
things. Well, it's 4-2. I'll tell you what, it could be 5-1 Jones.
Ah.
Does he make a ball?
Ooh, a nipper.
Oh, he got
a nipper.
Last one.
Yeah, nipper. But the football stuck on the rail.
Look at the action again. And the way he goes down on the stick and bends it.
Now, again, you're watching the traditional rules where you cannot use a side rail to break. You have to put the cue ball in the middle of the table and break. You can't use the rail.
I can make a ball.
Which makes it much tougher to break the balls.
What's this
here? You can't get as much leverage, Kevin, when you do that. When you're off to the side, you can really, you know, just explode them and hit them a little off center and the cue ball will run over.
14 in the corner.
Here he goes. He has to make one shot. This is not an easy shot, so he has to make this, and then he can breathe a little bit easier.
Now at 4-2, 4-2, it isn't anywhere close to being over.
Oh, no way. And even if he makes this shot, it doesn't mean that he's going to run out.
Well, Loree Jon is sitting there knowing that she can get to the table and run 5 in a row.
Well, it's got to be tough, though, when you've sat that long. You lose your rhythm. Can you get cold over there? And basically, that's what could possibly occur for Loree Jon Jones.
Does he make this hand right? Yeah, you're right. If she's sitting there, you know, Mike can get into this rhythm, as you said, Joel.
I didn't know the speed. I don't want to go behind those.
I don't even know if...
But I didn't want to wind up here either.
He'll hit this really firm to get back down. Look, it didn't go.
Uh-oh.
There you just see the real deal.
God,
about that cloth. Now, he hammered that almost as hard as he can, and it went like what?
A foot.
A foot,
oh,
yeah.
Easy run out if I don't get on that. Throw in if I don't get straight on that.
Throw ins, meaning that they're so easy that you can just throw them in. I mean, it's like.
Guy's comfortable on camera. Played himself in the Baltimore Bullet. You talked about it, Kevin. Color of Money, he was the technical advisor.
Yeah, he taught Tom
Cruise. Play 11.
Taught Tom 11 in the corner. Play, and loved playing with Paul Newman, who's a very good player. And was very close friends with the late Jerry Orbach. And Mike and I played.
Boy, if I get out here on the 10, it's over.
It looked like Loree doesn't want to hear about his problems.
Well, last year, Mike Sigel and I were teamed up at a celebrity event against Loree Jon and Jerry Orbach. And I missed one ball, the 7 ball for the championship. I missed pretty much a hanger because the pressure was so great. Jerry Orbach come flying out of the chair and ran the balls to win. And we lost, Mike and I lost the championship. So I know the pressure.
Oh, he tried to break.
Oh, give me a shot. Hope, baby. It's all right.
He really hit a good shot.
I'll take anything.
Yeah, but didn't he put this ball next to the 8?
Yeah, he did, but he really hit that ball better.
10 in the corner.
Came out. I mean, it looked like he was going to automatically bust the 13 out. He's in trouble here. He's going to really have to make a couple of real nice shots here. I mean, really nice shots. And I'll tell you what, he is really stalking everything, isn't he?
Yeah. And that's the advantage of with the International Pool Tour. There is no shot clock because just like in golf, looking at a putt, You need to size up your shots here, especially an eight ball. There's right. so much to think about, a not just making the shot.
Tough shot here.
Very tough shot, Joel. And not only that, if he makes the ball, then where's his position? He's trying to make it come all the way back across to him. He don't want to pull the trigger. I think he's just trying to get more airtime so he can talk some more.
I never thought I'd see somebody pace and pick up miles around a pool table like this guy.
I'll tell you what, it's a sport. Because the... Does he make it? No! Oh,
he moved again, Kevin. Did you see that?
He jumped
his body
up.
Moved.
Now, watch where it hits. If this was... Watch this. Goes boom.
Ooh, very
now,
close.
If that was a 5 1/4 inch pocket, instead of the 4 1/2, the ball goes in.
No doubt.
Also, if it was... See the fuzz on the cloth? If that was the fast cloth that you see being used today,
like
the ball also skids and goes right,
right
in.
Five times. Couldn't get on the 15. I get on the 15 with an angle, it's over. That's all it was.
It never stops with Mike Sigel. Now, the opening again for Loree Jon Jones in this game 7. She trails 4-2.
6 in sight.
Oh, good shot. I thought she was going to shoot another combination with a 4 and 1. Good shot, Loree.
Did she get on the right position here? Yeah.
I think so, yes. But she still has problems down there. The 7 ball is up against a stripe, so she has issues here that won't go away without some good playing.
Does she not? Don't.
Well, we're getting into the match pretty deep now. If she hasn't really settled in or her nerves gone away, I mean, I don't really know if they're going to, because, you know, usually the first game, you're going to be nervous no matter what sport you're in. But that all, you have to have that, and then it usually goes away. And she still looks like she's still a little shaky. I can't, like I said, you were in the green room. She was just running rack after rack.
Missed a ball.
But the tally light wasn't on. The cameras, the bright lights, it's totally different out here.
One
with $150,000 at stake and the biggest payday in the history of the sport.
Exactly right, Joe.
And if you're not going to get loose and in a rhythm by game 7, as you mentioned, you may never find it.
She might not. She really might not. And she's going to, I mean... Can't come from behind and beat this man. I don't really see it. And although she's one of the greatest come behind players of all times, but she really needs to loosen up. See, now she's faced with something here.
2 ball in a corner.
She just wants to hit the stripe ball and knock it out of the way, but she's got to be careful because the 8 ball's down there. She don't want to tie it up for him. She hit the wrong ball.
She hit buried
the 7.
Herself.
Yeah. She just. No, that was not a very good shot.
And she put that 7 on the rail.
I mean, she would be fortunate if that 7 goes past the 10, because she was really not trying to do that.
And now she's got 2 treble balls, the 3 ball on the rail here and the 7 ball.
Yeah, and she really, if the 7 don't go, she can't see the 3, and the 5's down at the other end of the table, and even if she makes it, it doesn't do her any good.
She's got a problem.
She might try to put the 7 in front of the hole and block the 10. That's another option she has. Players making the right decision at the right time in 8 ball is very critical. And when you're not thinking right or not playing good, you're not thinking right. When you're not thinking right, you're not playing good, and you just cause yourself more and more aggravation and problems.
Well, over 50 million people play pool in America, probably a couple hundred million around the world.
Oh boy, oh boy.
And 95% of the people play 8 ball.
Right.
And the problem is, it's not just about shot
7 ball in the corner.
It's about thinking out what to do at the table.
She's playing this ball. I tell you, I don't think it'll go by.
Oh, it does!
Oh, it
what
does.
A shot!
What a shot! It really was. Good shot, Loree.
That was a tough shot. And a gutsy shot.
She thought, and it was, if she don't make it, it's still going to block the hole.
Well, let's see if that starts to turn things around for Loree Jon Jones right now from a confidence standpoint.
Okay, but you got to remember, there's 2 balls left, and this 8 ball is hidden.
Right.
She's going to have to get some perfect shape.
Yeah,
unless she wants to bust it out here. But then she's sacrificing her shape for
three
the five.
Three ball in the corner.
I think she needs to go down and not worry about the eight and get position for the five. Let's see what she decides to do.
Five ball in the corner.
Exactly what you said.
Mike's looking at her like, hey, what are you doing there? Okay, she just needs to pocket the ball. And the cue ball will take a natural angle and over by where the piece of chalk is up in the right-hand corner, and she'll be fine. I have to believe she's going to make this shot.
Oh!
Oh!
Slam it, baby.
I think she was too worried about the lead than the make.
What do you see here, Kim?
Well, it just went off in her hand. She didn't even stroke it. It was just more of a hit.
Punch?
Yeah, a punch, a hit. She really had no rhythm to her stroke there. I mean, it was just a bad.
That's what amateurs do. They don't stroke the ball, they punch the ball. And Mike Sigel has been my coach for years. And when he first met me 15 years ago, he said, you're punching the ball instead of stroking through the ball. And that's exactly what she did right there.
Right. And she knows she's not playing well. And she's just sitting in the electric chair right now, what we call the electric chair. When you really can't do anything, you're trying, but nothing good seems to happen. What if she's being irritated about Mike constantly commentating his own shots and everything?
Well, you know, that's
can get under your skin.
Oh, in a heartbeat. I'd have to tell him, hey, be quiet here.
He's going to run this out. This looks pretty.
Yeah, it looks pretty automatic.
He's not going to miss that.
Look at her. She knows she could have won every single game here.
Game, Mr. Sigel.
There you go.
Mike Sigel commanding 5-2 lead.
Race to nine.
The score is now 5-2.
No kidding. Lori's starting to talk. Maybe. Into the rail. God.
Well, I should have won that anyway. The 15. I'm afraid of going behind the wheel. When I shot the 14, if I float on the end rail, I just got to play for the 10. I play those two, and the 13 goes, it was a throw-in. But I got dead on the 15. I couldn't do it. I got to gamble.
That's
you know
Bob.
What I'm saying? I mean, just got to land
caddy.
Right where I can't get out. You follow what I'm saying? If I hit it too hard, firm, like I want to, I'm behind the 1-4. I just got to go in the middle of the tail, play the 10, stop, those going there, 13 went to the side, it was a hanger.
You know, we should charge extra money for the seats behind Sigel.
Yeah,
he'll
really,
be talking to whoever's there.
Get some good knowledge, anyway.
Ready?
Here we go, game 8, 5-2 Sigel. And you saw Loree Jon Jones turn around to her husband, and he said, slow down. And because that last shot, I think she was worried about the leave more than the make. And she rushed, and she said, it's going 100 miles an hour.
Ooh, the 8.
Sigel.
Maybe she should start talking more.
He almost made the 8 here.
Right.
Now watch the 8 ball. There's the 8 ball, bam.
Well, the 1 does fall for him.
Now watch,
coming
here comes,
around
watch
the
this, watch
here
this.
It is.
The 8 ball almost goes in. If you make the 8 ball on the break, you automatically win the game. It happens 1 in a million times.
It doesn't happen very often.
Not
I'll
with the slow
what.
Cloth.
Son of a gun.
How do you really
Mystery.
Feel?
Mystery. Gee whiz.
He'll tell you.
It's a mystery. Look at this.
It's a mystery. He's already has everything mapped out in his mind what he's going to do. One good thing about pool, though, see, you have 6 pockets. So if one won't go where you want it to, there's always 5 more.
You ain't got a shot here?
Now he's actually figuring out where every ball is going to be pocketed. What pocket every ball is going
to
go
in. Boy,
I
would like to have a nice open table here. God darn it.
Now, Paul Servino's a great pool player.
Yeah, he loves to play pool.
I don't know what to do.
And as you mentioned, he's thinking about down the road. Not the first shot, but the shots in sequence. Just run the table
Correct.
And take a 6-2 lead.
Otherwise, he can
Nature
make 1-2-3
game.
Balls and then basically dig himself his own grave.
And, of course, open the table for that young lady, Loree Jon Jones.
Now we have 2 choices, solids or straight.
Play 5.
5 in the side.
And look at the shot he's chosen to take
a
for you viewers
shot.
At home. A very difficult opening shot. You don't see that too often.
Oh, he missed it.
I mean by a mile.
He missed it.
Cut it way too much.
Really hard. Now, did you hear him earlier talking to Servino? He said he can't see the side rail, the side pocket for some reason. He said he's not seeing that shot.
Well, it did look like he seen it there. He didn't even touch the
I
knuckles.
I don't see the sides at all. I just don't see him.
He's not seeing the sides. I wonder if it's the lighting.
If I make it, I probably
Yeah, but the lighting's perfect here.
No, I don't think it's
I can't
lighting.
See the sides.
Absolutely perfect.
The light he's saying.
I don't see the side pockets. I'm telling you, I don't see them.
Well, don't shoot him in the side, Mike. Shoot the corners.
It's easy for you to say.
Yeah, well, I'm sitting here. Another great opportunity for Loree Jon.
Five in the corner.
Again, it was an open table, so Loree had a chance to pick whatever she wanted, solids or stripes.
Just bounce it off the rail and shoot the four in the side. The four is right there by the side.
Four ball on the side.
Seven ball is the really only problem, but I don't really see it being a problem because there is a pocket for it. You notice she's playing pretty fast.
Maybe that'll help, though, get a rhythm. Well, she was very deliberate early in the match.
Right.
And we all thought maybe she was a little tight, a little tense. Right.
Think long, think wrong.
She can't fall behind, though, 6-2. She's got to have this game.
However, the big advantage is because winner breaks, she can easily break and run 5-6 racks in a row.
No doubt.
She has, and she did it in the green room right before the match started.
Three in the corner.
This is the key shot here. She could go get the 7 right now or play position for the 2 to get the 7. Let's see what she chooses to do. She chose to get it now, which that's very wise. See, again, she's coming up short on her position. Now she has to elevate the cue stick over the 9 ball.
Now, if that this was cloth, a fast, if yeah. that was a faster cloth, the cue ball would have no problem. But you have to stroke the ball more solid. And when you stroke harder, the margin of error goes up, which is why with this cloth, the traditional cloth, the same cloth that Moscone, Fats, Minnesota Fats used to play on, all those guys, it's a more difficult game.
7 in the corner.
Now she has a big problem here getting position. She's going to shoot the 7. The cue ball is going to carry him off the 14. And she has to be careful not to get behind the 11 or the 14 with the cue ball. Big shot.
She make it. She makes it. Did she get position?
11. I mean, it was just there staring her in the face.
Bam.
She just wasn't paying much attention.
And that's
to that.
Exactly what you said, yeah. And did she... She obviously, I mean, you saw that. It was pretty obvious. Was she just, like, brain freeze at that point because of the pressure?
Well, a lot of times, you know, when I see pressure, isn't, and we've all done it, the pressure, you forget how to play when the pressure is getting to you. So maybe that's, I mean, she's made so many mistakes so far. So maybe that's just it. Maybe she's just a little under the gun. And hopefully she'll get loosened up here. So she just has to call a pocket and kick the ball and try to make it because great players are great with kick shots. She needs to go over to the side rail and play in the corner.
Well, you know, this is the inaugural event, first event of the International Pool Tour, the start of the largest, most, what's the right word? Not prestigious, I guess it's the richest.
Significant.
Yeah, it's, but
in it's history, the, in the history of the sport, when you have elevated the sport to a new level like this has.
Yeah, it's the richest pool tour in history, and for the first time in the history of pool, a player can earn $1 million a year in prize money. That's unheard of. And the pressure that both Loree Jon and Mike, who pretty much have been retired for many years, they haven't been in competition, to come out and play two of the greatest players of all time facing off for the first time, man against woman, heads up, with all the traditional rules, with the traditional game of eight ball. I'll tell you, the pressure is something that people just can't comprehend. I don't
You're
think.
Right. I don't like the way she's doing. I'd rather kick the ball. I don't like this shot. She's going to have to make it curve too much. She really needs to get on top of it a lot more to make this ball. She'll be lucky to hit it the way she's aiming.
Oh, she's going to hit it on the back. Almost.
Called it. Missed it completely.
Yeah, you could just see
now,
it.
Now, look.
Well, she was smiling about it anyway, but I know one thing. Deep inside, she's not smiling.
Now, here's the rule. You have to hit the ball, your object ball. If you miss, which she did, it's a foul, or it's called a foul. Now Mike has cue ball in hand, anywhere on the table.
You pretty much are going to lose the game.
It's a foul.
You give the other player ball.
Sigel.
Great player
Mike
like
Sigel
Mike.
The ball. In
right. The stroke is getting a lot longer. The more games he gets ahead, the longer the stroke gets.
Hey, that's looser, correct?
Yeah.
In a good way.
In a good way. Oh, no doubt about it.
Can you have to call the ball
13 in the corner
and the pocket?
Yeah, just the ball in the play. It doesn't matter if, like if he shoots the 11 and it caroms off the 2 and goes in the same pocket, that's fine.
And if it's obvious, you can hear Charlie or Setti in the background with each call of each shot. Players don't have to call it. If it's not obvious, though, they have to let them know which way they're going.
Nine.
You know, Charlie Rossetti.
Nine in the corner.
That's the voice you hear, the referee. He refereed all the Moscone-Fats matches when Howard Cosell was announcing back on ABC's Wild Card.
Stays down on a ball.
You're exactly. That was back like in the 78, 77, yeah. Somewhere in that era, wasn't it?
Eight ball in the corner.
What a leave. A layup to close it out. I guess so.
I'll tell you what.
Bam. Game, Mr. Sigel.
All right, 6-2. Sigel taking advantage of every mistake by Loree.
It's like nerve-wracking, you know what I mean? If people just don't understand how pool is, it's like putting. You know what I mean? You just hit it with the wrong speed. Anything happens and you lose. You know what I mean?
Absolutely right. Slightest mistake, you lose.
Well, I was down there earlier in both green rooms, both Loree Jon and Mike, and they were like racehorses before the event.
I came good, but I just did. It's not like I feel this. I just, you know what I mean? I knew that would happen the first match. I told you that. I feel good. You know, just, I'm telling you, the side pockets. Tell them. I know.
That's Jim Rembry.
Mr. Sigel leads.
Jim Rembry is in the Hall of Fame as well, coming out of retirement to play in the International Pool Tour. One of the greatest players.
There are a lot of players that are going to be jumping at the opportunity. And the next competition coming up, and it'll be $1 million. So the start of game 9. And a good beginning for Sigel.
Another great break. Now you see, you're starting to see Mike loosen up a little bit here.
Just look at the spread he gets. He gets real good spreads. I mean, with all the balls at the table, some are going to be close to each other. But look, this is a very nice spread playing 8-ball.
Well, we've seen the action he gets off the break. It is phenomenal.
Now, being able to what's called break and run out in 8-ball is unbelievably hard, as every person at home watching knows. But when you see both Loree Jon and Mike have the capability.
Come on,
and
ball.
And
oh,
actually
I can't believe this.
Break
I
and run out.
I can't believe I did that.
Correct five, six racks
not
in a row.
Hit it hard enough.
Have we seen anybody break this and run out one rack yet?
I don't think so.
I don't either.
That's how hard it is.
Wow. I mean, these are two.
There's been at least one
legends.
Miss in each game. And let's remind us, as you mentioned, these are two Hall of Fame players.
15-9.
Loree, an 8-time world champion, Loree Jon Jones.
15-9.
Mike Sigel. Voted the world's greatest living player. It's on display.
Opposite hand. Looks like he's going to try to go up and break the ball out in the center of the table.
Don't do
it.
No, don't get unlucky. Please.
He's begging
now.
Now, he played to break that out.
He did.
He wanted it.
And he did it right-handed, and he's a left-hander.
That's exactly right. A lot of talent.
If he breaks and runs this rack, it's darn impressive.
11 in the corner.
They're probably on a handful of players in the world that could do that.
It's looking real good right now. I mean,
10 in the corner.
But everything's been looking good, and then all of a sudden he'll make something.
Now he's on a roll, though. He's taking no time. But you mentioned he's so good offhand. He's a lefty who can go righty. Have you ever seen anybody that good?
No, I haven't, to be honest with you. Mike has always been my favorite.
9-ball in the corner.
That's perfect speed.
Don't waste any time.
This could be the first break and run out that we've seen today, which could.
He's got to catch a train. This guy's in a hurry.
Yeah, he's really picked up the pace, hasn't he?
God almighty. I guess I'm playing it over there.
8 in the corner.
So that
whatever
wasn't
it takes.
That wasn't his first choice, in other words,
no,
right?
No. Let's put it together. Good thing about pool, you've got a lot of pockets.
See, this is a tough shot. He wanted to play that cue ball.
I didn't do that from day one anyway.
So that the 80 was playing in either the corner or the side, not way over there.
I can't imagine he missing 2 8 balls in one set. I am not going for it.
Oh, he makes
Look
it.
At that.
Don't scratch.
Oh, baby. Oh.
There we go. Tough shot.
And hard, he drilled it. Look how hard he shoots this ball. Wow. Didn't want it to roll off, did he?
No.
I like his finish, his follow through with it. And just turned it enough as we go down to the pocket camera we have. So a 7-2 lead now. Mike Sigel.
What is this? I mean, what's the deal here? I can't, like, get loose.
Yeah, he's playing pretty darn good, and he says
he's
not
can't
loose.
Get loose. Really, I mean, what is it?
It's that side pocket problem, obviously, but he's doing quite well for a guy that can't get loose at 7-2. First to nine, let's remind everybody, in this opening set, first to nine.
I tried to
take
pop
set
it
number
a little,
one.
You know, and the, well, that was like a throw-in. If all I got is going to 15 minutes, stop the nine, I hit it, didn't come over. You know, I mean, I'm afraid of getting too straight. You know, like that.
Now he's talking to no one, by the way. He's just saying, he's just looking in the crowd over there and just talking. That's why they call him the mouth.
Game
Here
10,
we go.
Mr. Sigel leads 7-2.
How do you think Loree Jon feels? He's saying he can't get loose, and Loree Jon's over there admittingly she can't get loose. Watch this big break. Watch the cue ball hop in the air. Look at that. Boy, hit those well.
And again, opens the table effectively. They're really not bunched together at all.
I think I know this.
He thinks he knows this. That's good. They're all straight in, right, Mike? He thinks he knows this. I like that.
Well, no one's been able to string racks together, which means break and run out, then break and run out again, then break and run out. We'll see if Sigel can break and run out two games in a row here.
Yeah, the balls are laying fairly nice for him. I mean, he still has to make the shots, but they're not. It's not really a bunch of difficult shots, one right after another. So he'll shoot that two and then try to make the three. I really, that's what he's looking at. Now he's changing, going to the 12. I think he'll take the little ones here. I really do. I don't think he wants to mess with that 14.
The little ones, for those at home, are the smaller numbers.
Right. The solids.
1 through 8, or 1 through 7. The solid ones, and the big ones are the 9. 15.
Yeah. Okay, solids and stripes. I don't know where I got the little ones and the big ones there. We're reverting way back.
12 and a side.
He sure did. Taking the stripes.
Former world number one Kim Davenport with us. How do you beat Mike Sigel if you can get the table back and you're Loree Jon Jones?
Combination 13.
Well, you have to keep him in the seat. She has to now. She's in a desperate major. She has to break and run out. Break and run out. Break. She can't tit-tat game for game.
She can't miss a ball.
No. She can't let Mike get back to the table. I mean, she might not get back to the table in this set.
It's got to be really tough to put doubt in his mind with the confidence he has.
Well, what I think going into this, I really believe this. I think 10. Loree Jon thinks she can win, and I think Mike knows he's going to win. That's my feeling. And I you know, that's just the way I see him. He's always felt
15.
That way when he's played.
15 in the corner.
Know he's going to win. Try to break it out here. Come up, hit the three. He wants to hit the three. No, he cut the 14.
Good shot.
Yeah, it was a good shot.
Now, that cue that he's using, by the way, a lot of people don't know, Mike made for many years when he retired from professional pool, made custom cues. And he made that cue himself in his own workshop. It's a $25,000 cue stick. He's using right now.
And it's still making him, isn't he?
He's actually not making them now because he's practicing every day for the International Pool Tour.
Right.
Now he wants to be the first $1 million player in the history of the game worldwide.
I don't blame him.
He does not look like a guy that has been away from the game for about a decade now.
I know, isn't it unbelievable that I really 13. Haven't played professionally?
13 in the corner.
And the last, I'll tell you what, this is why the pressure, you don't know what's going to happen with Sigel.
14.
He was in New York a couple years ago.
I'm going to look.
just to play in a professional tournament. And he put so much pressure on himself, he missed a shot and broke his cue stick. Oh, that was phenomenal.
Really Turned in the corner.
Something you see in baseball where a batter will take his bat over his knee after something develops at the plate that he didn't like.
Now, what you just saw there was a brilliant shot. Not only did he make the ball, but he had to play special English to move the cue ball three rails to get in position here.
And keep an angle. He'll just go in between the 2-6 and 7.
Eight in the corner.
There.
Perfect.
This will be the second rack in a row.
That's now. Two break and runouts.
Do not try to slow this guy down. He is wrapping up game number 10 decisively.
Game to Sigel.
8-2 Sigel.
And look at him moving.
Loree Jon is just sitting there wondering if she's going to get a chance to get even back to the table.
Now I like it. The side pockets.
Now I like it. He needs one game to win the set. Now I like it.
And I guess you can see the side pockets again.
Yeah, all of a sudden, right? Pointing at the cue ball.
I'm trying to avoid the side pockets, like you.
Mike the Mouth Sigel.
This has got to be a very bitter pill for that young lady. When you've had as much success as Loree Jon Jones, to be stuck in that chair this long.
I ain't done this in 10 years.
Well, this guy is just running. I mean, forget about the balls. What about his mouth?
Well, Loree Jon was convinced she could win this because she said, you know, Mike,
Jamie
Levin,
Mr. Sigel leads.
And when I played with her last year and with Jerry Orbach and Paul Savino in the celebrity tour, she never missed the ball.
Does he control it? Yes. He's sinks
the rail.
So he's got control of the table.
I'm taking stripes
here. A little cluster
here.
In the center, though.
It's not as wide open as we've seen over the last couple of racks.
So it's eight games to two. So this game is for the first set. It's the best two of three sets, race to nine. First play to win nine games in the set wins the set.
Cue vision on the break, and he didn't get the action that we saw previously.
No, it was kind of like, you know, they didn't really scatter a lot. And if you look at the side pocket, there's a mess over there. And in the center of the table, Mike's just a magic man when it comes to taking the right balls and doing this and doing that. A little meditation, Loree Jon. And you know she's thinking, just let me get one more chance at the table this set. I can run the whole set.
Play a 12.
She knows that, but she also knows that she may not get a chance to get back to the table.
This is for three and out. If Mike runs out here.
We are at Mandalay Bay in Las Vegas. Biggest payday. History of the sport. $150,000 going to the winner.
Whoa. God almighty.
How many times did he
11
that?
In the corner.
Just draw it back just a little.
Oh. Wow. That was pretty
phenomenal.
Good
Man,
job.
What a shot.
Exactly what he needed
14.
To do. Found some space.
Loree looked like, what was that, too?
Are they both going to go? And I get a shot at the 10. Is that what happens here?
You make the call.
He's getting awful brave now, calling shots all of a sudden. Going to make two and one and straight in on the other.
You think his confidence level's up?
I think it's up high.
14.
Look at this. He's playing both the balls.
No, don't do this. Hit.
Hit off it.
Now, notice right here, he played the 14 ball. That's what he called. How it goes in doesn't matter as long as you hit your ball first. So he has to hit a stripe ball first, which, boom, he does, into the 14, which is what he called in the side pocket.
Right.
That's a legal shot, and that's what the rules of 8-ball are. You have to call the ball and the pocket.
Straight would have been nice.
Well, at least he got space, so he can't complain about
that. I think
I would
have liked it from there.
He got a couple of inches away.
I'll play a
13. I think he shot it just a little too hard. He was going to shoot the 13, you know, in the same corner, but being back by the 3. Way he's rolling right now, I don't see no problem here, even on this difficult of a shot. Look at that.
Cuts it perfectly.
Perfect.
Oh!
Look at position and everything.
Look, it's perfect.
Wow.
Tough angle, but
watch
he makes it look easy.
See,
come back across. Look at that.
He knew that cue ball was going to hit the 10, so he had to hit it hard enough to get the position.
Right. I'll tell you what. Only people who handle this guy right now is Siegfried and Roy, I think. I mean, it's unbelievable what he's doing.
Win here. He takes set number one. Leading 8-2.
He might use the 5 here.
Does he know? He saw the side pocket there.
Boop. 15 in the corner.
Phenomenal last three games. Mike is loose. Mike is loose.
Captain.
Yes, running three in a row to close out set number one. Dominating.
Yeah, that's what I wanted.
Dominating the first set down the stretch.
Three breaks and three runouts. She sat there for the last three games, didn't have a shot.
Scott, this ain't easy here. What is it? I'm like playing for my lungs here.
9-2 Sigel.
How did we do?
How did you do? Well,
and then we'll be back for set two.
Like once he got control of the table, it was all
where
over.
I put my cue right here. Let's leave it.
And he got a rhythm. He got a cadence.
All right, let's go. Come on.
And then the confidence
where?
Just grew.
Everybody just stay still for another second.
Well, that's the Mike Sigel that I know right there. Running out like that. That's just phenomenal. Great showman, too.
So he takes the last three racks. He's decisive in the way he did it. And all of a sudden, he picked up the pace of play. None of those racks took any time at all. So it's going to be difficult now for Loree Jon Jones.
And they were tough racks as well.
Let's join Mary Strong now with Mike.
Mike, Loree Jon had some opportunities to run out. She made some mistakes and allowed you back in for you to take those wins.
Yes, I always had an advantage. And actually, the two games she won, I gave her. I mean, I knew I would be a little weak. I missed the eight ball one game. Actually, twice I missed the eight ball. Those were the two games, but I knew I was going to do that. It's a shame it's on the eight. You know, you feel a lot of pressure. This next set will go a lot easier, at least for me. I mean, she's under a lot. Now she's under a lot of pressure because I won the first set, and my game is geared in now. You know, I haven't done this in 10 years. It's easy to practice, but when you get out in front of a big crowd on TV, this and that, you know, you got to mentally get yourself. After I play in two or three events like that, no problem. But, you know, this is a lot of pressure. It's not even the money. I just want to win. I mean, I don't care if it was, you know, 100 million, sure. But there's just a lot of pressure. I have not done this, and you need to get seasoned in the limelight with the cameras and like that. So now I feel a lot more relaxed, you know.
Now you need to win this next set
yes.
in order to win the entire title.
Yeah.
What needs to happen in order for you to do that?
Well, what I did there, if my breaks kicks in, see, I ran two or three racks and out there, see, and I figure I can string racks together, and I don't think she is capable of doing that to a degree. So I may run three, four, five racks twice, possibly, but she has to beat me two sets now. That's going to be a task. If I win one of the next two, if I win the next one, it's over. And if she happens to win, she still has to beat me another one, and that's never been done, but I don't want to curse myself. But, you know, I mean, anything can happen, but, you know, if she has to beat me two sets race to nine, that's very difficult, you know.
All right, Mike, good luck. Back up to you guys.
Thanks. Alongside Kevin Trudeau, the founder of the IPT in this World 8-Ball Championship, and as Mike Sigel just said, all the pressure now is on Loree Jon Jones.
It's really true. Obviously, his confidence level's high, but, you know, Loree Jon, as I mentioned, is one of the greatest comeback players in the history of the game. And the great thing about this format, Joel, is, yeah, she lost 9-2 in the first set, but now it's the second set. It's the best two of three sets. So they're 0-0. They're going to lag for the break, and Loree Jon can easily get up there and run 4, 5, 6, 7 racks, just like Mike ran the last three racks. She can get up there and run racks. I was with her in her dressing room on the practice table, and she never missed a ball. She broke and run out. She has the capabilities, and she certainly has the fight in her.
There's no doubt she's very capable. Also, Kim Davenport, a former world number one, you have faced Mike before. How do you get under his skin? How do you take control of the match?
Well, maybe she needs to talk just a little bit more. I mean, Mike's been doing all the talking, but what she really needs to do is like Mike did the last three games, just leave Mike in his seat. She needs to break and run out, break and run out, break and run out.
We get ready for set number two, but first let's join Mary Strong with Loree Jon Jones.
Loree Jon, there were some opportunities there for you, but some very costly mistakes there throughout that set.
Big time. I'm as tight as a drum right now, to be very honest. And, you know, the good part about it is that I saw that there were opportunities. He's not, you know, he got some breaks. I tried to break up a ball three times, didn't break it up. The other time, you know what I'm saying? There's just a couple things. I missed ball that definitely I shouldn't have missed. You know, a couple mistakes on my side and were very costly.
Do you think if you relax a little bit, you can turn this game around for yourself?
Absolutely, because, you know, he's not, there were no strings of eight balls going, you know, eight ball racks, you know, he didn't run forward out on me or anything, so I had an opportunity almost every rack.
You need to win this next set to stay alive. What's going through your mind right now?
Nothing, just to get out there and have fun and play.
Okay, good luck out there.
back up to you guys.
All right, thank you, Mary. We get ready for set number two. Game number one after a convincing win in the opening set. So many celebrities here with us, like Anthony Anderson, a barbershop. Also, Pauly Shore, great comic actor, now with the series Mind in the Store. And rapper DMX. And everybody had an unbelievable time last night at the MGM. It was a great party, and all part of a very historic time for pool.
We're going to leg. Loree Jon Jones, Mike Sigel, please leg for break.
Our referee, Charlie, are setting in the background. Well, Loree Jon Jones won the flag to start this match. It didn't make any difference, though, because all the momentum after that belonged to Mike Sigel.
But she can easily break and run four, five, six
brutal
racks in a row.
Leg here. Look
at this.
Mike said it best. I'm brutal on this.
2 feet.
Well, I hit it.
They're both laughing. They were both terrible lags, but Loree Jon won again.
Thought I hit that perfect.
Thought I, and I hit
I
it.
I know. It's slow now.
I noticed Mike said the cloth is slow
You're
now.
Right.
We picked up on it without even hearing Loree Jon Jones say it. And she mentioned it to Mary Strong. I was as tight as a drum. Let's see if she loosens up, tries to get into the rhythm, has some fun with this match now.
She made a ball. She made a ball.
And that's again, a beginning.
Almost scratched there. Now, an eight ball in the professionals, IPT Tour, you make any ball, which she made a ball, a stripe ball, she can pick either solids or stripes. It's her choice. Because when you make a ball on the break, you shouldn't be penalized.
Nine ball.
Nine in the side.
She's shooting the right ball here. The stripes are the right balls to shoot.
That was a better stroke.
She could just start early, come out early, and win a game or two, get up a game or two. I mean, it's so much more confidence she would have.
Yep.
Oh, it's just, she just doesn't have it right now. That's just too bad. She would never have missed that shot.
Now, again, the size of the pockets. These are 4.5. Watch how close. See the difference that you can see here clearly. The traditional size of the pocket is 4.5 or even a hair under 4.5 inches, which means you have to be accurate to make the ball. And if you're off even by a half an inch, you miss. Your opponent is now shooting.
These pockets might be bothering her. You might be right, Kevin. I mean, because she has missed so many shots. It's just not like Loree Jon.
And she has not been on the table long enough. We talk about that period of transition, adjustment to the slower cloth and the tighter
one
pockets.
The
she hasn't been out there that long to really make a lot of adjustments.
To get into that rhythm.
Right. Mike has controlled the table completely in set number one. He won 9 games to 2.
But the thing about it is the last 3 games,
four
he broke and run out.
It's getting late, I guess, right?
He started to open up his game at the end, breaking and run out. So let's see what he can do in this set. He was tight at the beginning, but opened it up the last 3 games of the last set.
Don't hit it perfect. Oh, that's too good.
Who is he talking to? Anybody that'll listen, I believe. She really don't want to hear that.
Right. It's not that entertaining for Loree Jon Jones.
Six ball.
Voted the greatest living pool player in the world.
Oh. As he should be.
Three ball in the corner.
Pretty much out of competition for the last 10 years because there was no money in pool. Now with the International Pool Tour, millions of dollars in prize money.
Five ball in the corner.
He's playing this perfect.
And he's back, and he's going to be in Orlando again.
Is he gonna run another rack here?
It looks like it. I mean, look at that stroke. He's really letting it out right now.
8 ball on the side.
There's a game one.
Right. Made it look easy.
Now, Kim, you're playing in the International Pool Tour. You'll be playing, obviously, against Mike Sigel, who's going to be on the tour as well.
Yeah, you saw that shot. Huh? I know.
The 150 top players in the world are playing. When they're seeing... And you're watching.
I'm trying to get on the four and go across or the six. I figure if I hit the five, it's over. Six, boom, three, right? Well, I hit it good, huh? Yeah. Yeah, right.
And you played against Mike years ago when he was in stroke. How's he playing now?
Well, other than just a little bitty, a couple of mistakes, which will get better, you know, missing a couple little balls will get better as he plays longer and in time and he gets used to the competition again. It looks like everything's together still. He's still, his rhythm, his pace, his form, everything still looks very good. Tell you what, players watching him play, I'm going to tell you something. They're going to say, hey, I'm going to be a little nervous when they draw Mike Sigel. Look at that.
No. Oh.
Look at, got the double kiss. Oh.
Yay.
Almost scratched
real
twice.
Close. Hey. That would have been his third scratch already on the break in the match.
Watch, it almost gets kissed in twice.
You can see the difference in the breaking capabilities between Mike and Loree Jon.
Yeah, Loree Jon, God bless her, looks like she's throwing a sponge at him when she hits.
Never a doubt. Who said that? How do you like this? Well, I don't think I got a shot. How do you like that? You ever see this before? I like stripes, I know that. Gosh almighty. Unbelievable. Well, maybe not.